Welcome back to the channel, guys. Glad to have you as always. And if you're not subscribed, go check us out on IG. I'm gonna put it right down here again for you. Go check out the page for some more exclusive content on these upcoming shotgun videos. And man, do I have a surprise for you guys. First off, just a huge shout out to Savage Arms. They are one of our biggest sponsors this year, and they have sent us a couple shotguns to test and review and hunt with for you guys to give some honest feedback on their all-new Renegade shotgun. We've got it out with us today in the truck, and we're going to do a full unboxing video, and we've got some huge plans for this thing this year, especially this off season, so you guys are not going to want to miss a second. Also, a huge thanks to Kevin Grant and his family, owners of Sons of Grant's Pawn and Sporting Goods here in North Georgia, my hometown, Dalton. They were super accommodating as always, so if you guys are ever in North Georgia and need a firearm, ammunition, or other sporting goods that they've got in their shop, go check them out, tell them I sent you, and just give them a call, ask for Kevin or Lisa, and they'll take great care of you. But as always, guys, we got a good one coming for you, so stay with us. Guys, so here it is, finally in hands on the channel. And again, just a huge shout out to the team over at Savage Arms for hooking this up. This is the all new auto loading shotgun from Savage, otherwise known as the Renegauge. So the reason this shotgun was invented was they wanted to get into the auto loading shotgun game and have something that not only was comparable to your higher end brands, but have something that could compete in all weather conditions with just a superb gas system, which we'll get into in a little bit, but be something that was super reliable, super rugged, well-maintained, and something that anybody could hunt with from the opening day of dove season, like we're gonna do, to the hay fields of early goose, on out to like the plains of Oklahoma, the flooded timber of Arkansas, you know, all kind of scenarios, even into your spring turkey woods that we're standing behind here. So guys, again, we're gonna take just a deep dive into this thing, and I want to give you my first impressions. Right out of the box, without doing anything to it, no reading manuals, no research, I really, really, really like the ergonomics. So what I mean by that, ergonomics on a shotgun, first of all, the fitment of this thing, they give you just a ton of options to fit this thing to fit really any shooter. So from a young gun to a seasoned veteran to maybe a female that's getting into it, you can truly customize this shotgun to how you like to wing shoot. So if you want to raise the comb height, this thing is flexible. You've got three interchangeable pieces. You've got three interchangeable butt pads with different lengths of pull. So lengths of pull is the distance from your shoulder to the trigger, obviously. So people have longer arms, shorter arms, so you can really just dial that thing in. Again, this thing is the model that they call the Field. So there's a couple different iterations of this shotgun. There's a turkey, a waterfowl. Since we are going to have this thing dipped by my guys over in Cadiz, Kentucky, Edward Etheridge and Jerry Etheridge, we just opted for the Field model since this just comes with the gray stock and the melanite finish. So we were fine with that. But getting back to out of the box, I loved how this thing went together. Just a super simple procedure. The gas system is up here. Obviously the drive gas system that we'll get into in a little bit later. Got your magazine cap. A really nice bead, a really nice fit and finish on this thing. This shotgun is priced around the $1,300 to $1,400 range. So when you hear that, you instantly think, you know, the big three manufacturers and shotguns. Well, to compete with that, you really have to be out of the box, really nice finish. Everything goes together perfectly. There's no weird gaps anywhere. I love how the stock meets up with the receiver. You got a really nice trigger guard that's ergonomic. You got a really nice loading gate here for your shells. You've got a huge oversized bolt handle. So when this thing is cycling day in and day out with gloves on, you can reach up there and grab it. If you need to go safe, move blinds, remove situations if you're waterfowl hunting, getting in and out of your layout blind, that's gonna be super easy to make that thing safe. You've got a huge bolt release there, which is awesome. I can feel that in the dark with gloves on, whatever the situation is, a big old open trigger guard. You've got a cross bolt safety that is oversized as well and easy to get to. So far, man, I like the fit and finish. I like the feel. I like how this thing points just naturally. I don't think I'm going to have any trouble there. Again, the finish on the rib is super high. I feel like I get a good purchase on that thing. I know you guys can't see that in the camera possibly, but it does come standard with a red fiber optic that looks like a higher end one. So like this is actually bolted to the gun. I like to see that. That is just attention to detail and quality. You'll also know this thing is topped with a rectifier diamond series. That's right, boys. Alan Tootin over at Rectifier Chokes hooked it up again. We're gonna go over that in just a little bit on what's in the box. But fit and finish on this gun, couldn't be happier. I like how it points. I love the ergonomics. I love the styling. And that's the first thing that attracts you to this shotgun off the rack. So when you see this thing up next to Beretta, Benelli, you know, Franke, other shotgun makers, what's going to make you pick this thing up? And you're going to be first attracted to the looks. You're going to be drawn in by the ergonomics. And I think you're going to be drawn in by the reliability later on. We're going to test that out later. But let's go ahead and get into what's in the box, what comes with this gun when you make the investment. And let's get into it, boys. All right, guys, let's take a look at what you get in the box when you purchase a shotgun like this from Savage. So let's take a look here. So the first thing that I notice, just like you guys will, it's attention to detail. So when I picked this gun up from Grant Sporting Goods, I noticed the case. The case is extremely well made. You've got laser foam cut places for everything. The gun comes broken down, of course, like most shotguns. But this case is made to travel. So whether you're going out of state or cross country, whatever the case may be, that shotgun is going to be protected. So you've got room for your chokes, you know, extra accessories, your barrel, your action, your receiver, your extra pieces to get that shotgun fit perfect for the shooter. But it's going to be protected, a lockable foam hard case. That is awesome that that is included in the purchase. So moving on, we've made a huge deal about the fitment on this thing. So the fitment is absolutely incredible. Like I mentioned earlier, you're not going to find that from other companies, especially guys that are competing in the waterfowl segment. It's like a one-size-fit-all for most shotgun shooters. So this gun takes it an extra step further. You're going to get three sets of comb risers and length of pull adjustments that comes with each individual recoil pad. So you don't have to use the same recoil pad every time you go out. You're going to get three of those. You're going to get three comb adjustments. So you can take that gun from super streamlined, low fit for waterfowl, wing shooting, dove, pheasants, quail, mallards, geese in the field. You can take that straight to the turkey woods if you need a little bit more adjustment off the rear stock for that red dot or that optic that you're running in the spring turkey woods. That is huge. That is awesome. So you can take this shotgun truly from September all the way to the end of May and enjoy it that entire time. That is awesome that they include that. Also, a super, super nice attention detail that I noticed is that they are not just using a run-of-the-mill choke tube company to put chokes in that box with the shotgun. So they are using a company called TruLock. I believe they are local to us here in Georgia, but they are well known for making very high quality choke tubes. So the three flush fit chokes that you get from Savage are going to include the modified, the full, the improved cylinder, and it does come with a choke tube wrench and a very nice padded choke tube box. So you can throw that in a blind bag or just take it with you on the road if you're not going to use the case they provide. Again, you've got a manual, you've got your gun lock to always be safe with a firearm. We preach that here on the channel, and you've got room for everything. So the stuff that comes in the box is going to completely equip you out to go take that shotgun afield and be successful and have it fit well. If it fits well, you're going to shoot well and you're going to feel good about your shotgun experience. So again, huge shout out to Savage for putting all that into the purchase. Again, this gun is about $1,300, $1,400 range. So that is just something, again, that makes them stand out from the rest of the pack. All right, guys. So next, I want to show you just how easy this shotgun breaks down. So this is how it arrives to you from Savage, broken down in that super nice hard case that we just went over. I'm going to have to remove this magazine cap. That's probably the first step. You want to always put that back so you don't lose that component. But you are next going to take your barrel and receiver. You want to slide that over your magazine tube. This thing goes together like butter, man. I mean, it is just the fitment and the quality is super nice. Something that you're going to be able to do time and time again. I do have the migratory plug in, which is something that you got to have. So don't ever forget that. Just like that. There we go. We've got a finished Renegauge ready to go hunting or skeet shooting or whatever you guys are doing. Again, the takedown of that is super easy. All you're gonna do is take the magazine cap. You can hear that engagement in there, so it is locked down tight. You're gonna take that, put it somewhere safe, and the barrel and forearm come off just like that. It's just how super easy this drive gas system is. So the drive gas system is Savage's patent pending dual regulating inline valve system. So you're gonna see these two holes right here in the very front facing part of the barrel lug, if I can get that to focus for you guys. That is where the excess gas is expelled out, so you don't have those stupid cuts in the forearm coming down on your hand or a chance to get gummed up. They're going straight away from the gun just like the shot is, so that's pretty cool. You can see just how easy this is to clean. So what I worry about as a waterfowler is how dirty is this thing going to get and how hard is it going to be to clean in the field. This is it. There is not a lot of moving parts here. These springs that you see that assist in operation, they don't come out. That's it. That is the one gas ring, and that, you hear that? That is a captured, some kind of a C-clamp. That thing is captured, so I don't have to worry about that falling out in the blind if I have to take this apart and clean it for whatever reason. That is it. That is the entire thing there. That is the drive gas system. So when I wipe this thing down and get all the carbon buildup off of it, I'm going to put it back exactly the way I found it. This flange piece with the shoulder goes facing you. And just like that, it's in there. So that's how it should look. That's how it's going to operate. And that's all. That is all I could see. Also, they do include the barrel is something very, very cool that I haven't seen on a lot of shotguns, if I can get this to focus. This 28-inch barrel is fluted. So a couple reasons. Obviously, it's aesthetically pleasing, but the main function is to cut down on weight. So everything you can do to cut down on weight for that duck or goose hunter is huge for that guy, that hunter in the field that is using this day in and day out. So that is the takedown operation of the gas system. To take this bolt out, it's going to remind you a lot of some other shotguns you may have had. You're going to take this rotating bolt head, push it back. This bolt handle comes out super easy. This slides completely out. You do have an operation rod in here that assists in recoil management. So when that bolt slides back, it's going to engage that in the pistol grip. You've got two Phillips head screws in this recoil pad, so taking this off is just as easy as 1, 2, 3. Also, the comb riser here is completely customizable. You just pull this thing off, it comes out. It's molded in there. And again, it's just, they just make it too easy for you. But also, the purpose for that drive gas system is that it can self-regulate. So meaning you can go from the lightest 2 3/4 field load, like 7.5 or 8 shot for doves or shooting skeet loads, straight to your heavy Magnum 3-inch steel shot. So it's super, super versatile. It's meant for reliability, so that gas system can self-regulate and make sure that bolt operates every single time. Another great feature that most shotguns, you know, kind of have as a second thought is the loading port. So the loading port for this thing is already sculpted out, so you can easily, with gloves or adverse conditions going on, you can get those shells back in the magazine and get back in the hunt quicker than usual. And I have noticed that with the aluminum follower that you'll see that's designated red inside of there, that is just the most easiest operation of most new shotguns out of the box that I've experienced as well. This thing is threaded for chokes for the mobile choke system, which is like Beretta / Benelli. I'm sure you guys have a pile of these things like I do in your arsenal for other shotguns. So you're gonna have a plethora of stuff to choose from that's in store, easy to source for turkey, ducks, geese, dove, skeet loads, whatever you shoot there, you're gonna be able to find. As you guys are probably staring at, this is a chrome unfinished diamond series by my boy Alan at Rectifier Choke Tubes. He hooked it up again. This is the modified or the mid-range for, you know, those close in flooded timber or early goose situations. Then also you have a long range version, which I've got in the truck here, that we're going to use for early goose season. So shout out to Alan, thanks again for hooking that up, man. This is the only choke tube you're going to see run in this shotgun. And you guys can see we love the finish here. This is the field model, as we talked about earlier, but I am a big fan of some custom gun work. So we're going to send this gun and its brother up to Cadiz, Kentucky to see Jerry and Edward Etheridge of Etheridge Hydrographics. They're going to cerekote this one, dip the fore end in stock, and then they're going to do Candace's gun in new bottomland. So you guys are going to get to see that whole process. We got a whole separate video. I believe we're going to clip that into the shooting portion whenever we go up to Barnsley Gardens with Kyle and do some skeet range, some pattern stuff, stuff that you guys want to see, I know. But guys, again, thanks so much for tuning into the channel. If you need anything as far as information on the Savage Renegauge, check out savage.com, look up the Renegauge, get all the specs, the pricing, information on the other models. If you need anything from me on my end, I've got one in hand on the channel, so I will answer the questions as best as I possibly can. Again, thanks so much for tuning into the video. We've got a lot coming on the off season. Super excited to bring it to you. And as always, guys, we'll catch you on the next one.